my bass guitar can now exhale smoke. Let me show you how. The effect I was going for was very clear in my head, it had some key parts. The smoke had to come out slowly, it definitely had to be thick, and I also wanted the smoke to be interacting with my picking or plucking hand. So you may have noticed I need to make some smoke or smoke look-alike. It didn't take much research to narrow the options down to one, personal vaporizers.
Quick disclaimer, in this video I'm not by any means advocating for smoking and no nicotine or other psychoactive substances were used throughout this project.
No baby formula, no chili powder.
No, chili pea's my signature.
Not anymore.
That being said, I can't be ungrateful to the vaping community over the wide range and availability of small fog machines. I climbed the learning curve the hard way though, so here's a quick sped up crash course in vaporizers. The atomizer is the ensemble of a heating element that can be a mesh or a coil combined with some sort of a wick and is placed inside of a small tank that gets filled with the juice, some glycerin-based solution. The heating element needs electricity, there's a vast spectrum of options, unregulated voltage, regulated voltage, up to using PWM or even a microcontroller and going crazy with Arduino logic. Still with me, MTL Multilung. Is designed for smaller amounts of smoke, so high resistance coils and smaller airflow inlets. Direct to lung, on the other hand, is for big clouds, sub-ohm coils, drawing more power and generous inlets. With all that info, I did a little shopping. Version 1. I had to lie to the pharmacist that these are for my kids' kindergarten science experiment. They'll never know they were actually for my own kindergarten science experiment. This works so well though that it pushed me in the wrong direction. So in version 2 I designed something similar, flatter, with a separate inlet and outlet. I also wanted to have the outlet as large as possible to have the smoke come out as slow and thick as possible. I set myself this idea that no fan should be involved because it would rush the smoke out in a stream rather than a cloud. This was a total fail though and I realized I don't actually want this to be fully manual because I will need my hands free, so I came up with a cunning plan. In version 3, I started by building a very bare bones enclosure to catch the air from a radial fan. I wanted to do a test and it worked better than I expected. I can have a fan push the fog through a hose. That's important. I feared that the vapor would break up, but it's actually quite brilliant. At the exhaust end, the fog drifts out slowly, smoothly, pushed by the static pressure. Passing the test, I built a standalone battery-powered unit with a radial fan creating some static pressure behind the mouth-to-lung atomizer. It works well and I really really like this one. If the atomizer wouldn't choke all the time due to the air inlets being on the bottom, small and badly designed if you ask me. So in version 4 I changed it up. I found a nice direct to lung atomizer with a large inlet placed on the side, so I changed to a centrifugal fan for better static pressure and also easier to focus the airstream. The radial fan would generate quite a bit of turbulence that was working against itself really. This combo works so well that it's final. The next iteration is just about the electronics, so actually let's get into that. To power everything, I'm using a lithium-ion cell, which seems to have enough power output for both the fan and the heating element. To charge it, I'm using the ubiquitous TP4056, which is okay. It can't output the 10 amps that the heater needs though, so I just hooked the heater straight to the battery, but then I started waking up in the middle of the night screaming, "Overdischarge!" Not really, but the battery chokes out after a while. So on Electronoob's suggestion, I got myself one of those 1S BMSs that should protect against that. Oh, I also added a microcontroller to have some logic behind the MOSFET, so I designed the PCB to clean everything up. I ordered it on PCBWay.com and it came out perfectly and super pretty in red. PCBWay is the sponsor of this video. They make makers' dreams come true. I'm particularly grateful to them because I overcame my fear of designing custom PCBs. They made it so affordable and available, so I wasn't terrified about making mistakes anymore. And mistakes I definitely made, you'll see a bit later. Look at that silkscreen graphics, gorgeous. Anyway, let's continue the unboxing. PCBWay also offers 3D printing, and I got this 3D printed in nylon. But I made a major mistake, I overcompensated tolerances like I would do for my printer on damp filament, and now the fit is just unusable. I also heard nylon is notorious on shrinking. These were two different designs for a quick attach port of the smoke hose to the body of the guitar. I'll need to rethink this. And I saved the best for last. PCBWay also CNCs. And this front hole cover was CNC'd in aluminium and anodized black. The details are just something else. And it has a very premium feel. I'll press fit some magnets into it, but let's move on for now. For the body of the guitar, I'm going to respectfully tear it a new pickup slot here in the middle. You're starting to see how the gorgeous black aluminium cover plays in, right? Then drill a large hole through the whole body and then cut a channel on the back to run a hose towards the edge of the guitar body where it doesn't sit against my body. Easy, I mean terrifying, right? I got myself a brand new manual router mill that I learned how to use live while doing. Best way to learn, they say. Not sure if they meant straight on the finished product though. But I'll be cheating though. This plastic depositing CNC will build some jigs first. Then I'll manually follow those jigs. Come on, admit it. It turned out pretty neatly for a first time. Drilling was a bit scrappier, but I got there eventually. I also dremeled quite a bit off camera. The channel on the back now. I'm happy how this turned out. And I'm even happier that I still have a working bass guitar. Now I can also play like this for a bit of a nightmare fuel. Going in this way, coming out the other side. This looks so good. I think I need more CNC'd metal on this instrument. Hell, everything needs more CNC'd metal. But we need to go back to the electronics for a little bit. Remember when I said about mistakes? First of all, the charger module has an onboard boost converter, but it makes so little sense to me that I completely missed that issue while designing the PCB. The positive output of the boost is shared with the positive of the battery, which really means the boost converter creates a new ground reference, so there's no way to have a common ground between the microcontroller and the battery. And I want to be able to control the n-channel MOSFET to supply high current to the coil. For that I need a gate and a source to have the same ground reference, while the source comes from the battery and the gate comes from the microcontroller. So I don't really have a choice but to take out the charger module, and I'll just attach it to the battery somehow for charging. Next issue, the BMS seems not to want to open when it's placed after the MOSFET. I'm clueless to why, but I'm sure there's a pretty logical explanation, so I moved it before the MOSFET. Remember when I said the PCB will clean everything up? Yeah, well, then the next version will definitely be clean. So maybe subscribe for base ache.